Good morning or good afternoon to everybody. I'm Federica Giordano and I'm a postdoc in Francesca Taraballi Lab at Houston Methodist Research Institute in Texas. Today I would like to present you my project on Ponatinib Biomimetic Nanoparticle for the treatment of osteosarcoma. So just a curiosity, osteosarcoma is not a kind of new disease, but actually arises 75 million years ago in dinosaurs. So they recently discovered, examining a fibula of Centrosaurus, that the heel fracture was not a normal malformation, but comparing it with the human fibula with osteosarcoma, after the examination, they find out that was actually osteosarcoma. So maybe now it's time to make osteosarcoma to extinct and not only the dinosaurs. So just a little bit of background. Osteosarcoma is the most common pediatric bone tumor that actually arises from primitive mesenchymal bone-forming cells and mostly affects adolescents. Unfortunately, the 5-year survival rate is still less than 70% due to the development of lung metastasis and the absence of specific molecular target. In fact, the only known mutations are in p53 or in the retinoblastoma protein. In the clinical scenario, osteosarcoma includes symptoms like bone pain, swelling, and the worst case, also fractures. It is usually diagnosed by biopsies, X-ray, CT scan, MRI, and test serum tumor markers. The current treatment mostly rely on chemotherapy, surgery, or a combination of both, but unfortunately, the 5-year of survival rates is still very low for this treatment. So think about each year about 800 to 900 of the new cases of osteosarcoma are diagnosed in US, and half of them are actually diagnosed in children. So what we can do to help this small fighter? Unfortunately, the current approach are not sufficient to eradicate the tumors. In fact, regarding the chemotherapeutic approach, there is still high level of drug resistance to the current chemotherapeutic agents, and there is high level of severe adverse effects related to them. And regarding the target therapy approach, there is still the need to identify new molecular target involved in osteosarcoma development and progression. And among the different possible targets, tyrosine kinase have been considered as possible target for the treatment of osteosarcoma, and consequently, tyrosine kinase inhibitor. Among them, ponatinib, which is a multi-tyrosine kinase inhibitor discovered for the first time for the treatment of chronic and acute leukemia. Recently, has been applied to a variety of tumors thanks to its affinity for more than 40 kinases, and it has also been applied for the treatment of a small subset of sarcoma. In particular, since it's able to efficiently target and inhibit SARC, which is one of the most important proteins involved in osteosarcoma development and progression, it took our attention as a possible treatment for osteosarcoma. Unfortunately, ponatinib triggers severe vascular adverse events, and for this reason, its therapeutic application has been limited. So, what we can do in order to increase treatment efficacy, what we can do in order to reduce ponatinib toxicity, and how we can make it worse in order to use it as a possible treatment for osteosarcoma? In this scenario, nanotechnology offers a powerful tool for cancer therapy, and in particular, second generation of nanoparticle has improved nanoparticle properties like longer blood circulation time, ability to escape the immune system. They can act as a bioactive tool, so they can be modified in order to reach a specific goal. They can increase the selective targeting and overcome drug resistance and reduce side effect of the encapsulated drug into the nanoparticle. So, in order to increase the selective targeting and reduce the side effect related to the drug, thanks to our expertise in our lab, we decide to develop a second generation of biomimetic nanoparticle that we call leucosome. So, learning a lesson by nature, we decide to mimic leukocyte behavior and ability to target the inflamed tissue. So what we basically what we have done, so we mimic the ability of leukocytes, thanks to the expression of protein like LF1, to efficiently bind the activated endothelium thanks to interaction between LFA and NACAM1. So we decide to use the same protein in order to formulate our biomimetic nanoparticle in order to better targeting the inflamed endothelium. As you know, the tumor is usually surrounded by inflamed vasculature, so in order to better target the inflamed vasculature and better reach the tumor. So how we have done? Basically, we formulate this particle. We took leukocytes, we cultivate them, then we extract membrane protein from them, and then we formulate this biomimetic nanoparticle. So basically, we have the liposome that are the nanoparticle control, so just lipid-based formulation, and then we have the leukosome that are basically a lipid formulation with membrane protein in the lipidic bilayer. So as you can see, we can also modify this lipid-to-protein ratio in order to achieve a better targeting, increasing the protein content inside the nanoparticle. Then we usually characterize this particle for physiochemical and biomimetic properties, and then we assess the effect, like toxicity and association with different cells and the uptake with different cell lines. And lastly, we demonstrate an enhanced in vivo targeting of this platform in two different mouse models, a local area inflammation and a triple negative breast cancer. So basically, thanks to this first result, thanks to this data, we decided to encapsulate ponatinib for the first time into this biomimetic nanoparticle, so inside leukosome. So as I said before, ponatinib shows severe cytotoxic effect. So for this reason, we want to encapsulate inside this nanoparticle in order to reduce the toxicity, and thanks to the nanoparticle in order to better target the tumor lesion. So the goal of my project is to assess ponatinib targeting ability and efficacy in a murine model of osteosarcoma. So basically we inject this nanoparticle IV in order to better target the tumor lesion and avoid the release of the drug, or at least reduce the release of the drug in the healthy tissue. And thanks to ponatinib ability to block pathway involved in osteosarcoma development and progression. So we basically choose two different murine osteosarcoma cell lines, one derived from bone primary tumor and one derived from lung metastasis in order to resemble a more aggressive tumor. So as you can see from the immunofluorescent staining, you can see that the particles that are the one labeled in red, you can see that there is a significant accumulation of both lipo and leuco at 24 hours in all the two cell lines. So we can see that the particles are efficiently being uptaken from the two different osteosarcoma cells. Then we were wondering if ponatinib nanoparticle show a good ability in killing osteosarcoma cells, comparing it with ponatinib as a free drug. So as you can see from the cell viability assay, if you follow the black, gray, and blue line, we demonstrate the ability of ponatinib nanoparticle in efficiently killing osteosarcoma cells with a similar efficacy of ponatinib, or even better with a drug cytotoxicity improved of 30% for some cell lines. Since I said that ponatinib shows severe adverse effect on endothelial cells, we decide to evaluate the effect of ponatinib nanoparticle treatment also on endothelial cells. As you can see, there is a significant accumulation of lipo and leukosome at 24 hours, also in endothelial cells, but the ability to kill endothelial cells was only reached at higher concentration compared to the one applied on osteosarcoma cells, as you can see from the cell viability graph. So we demonstrate that the treatment resulted less toxic on the endothelial compared to the osteosarcoma cells. That was basically our goal. Since I said that ponatinib and ponatinib nanoparticle showed a similar killing capability on osteosarcoma cells, we were also wondering if they were acting on the same pathway, so if they were targeting the same molecular targets. And so we focus our attention on AKT, that is a downstream effector of SARC. As I mentioned before, is one of the most important proteins involved in osteosarcoma development and progression. And we evaluate the ability of ponatinib and ponatinib nanoparticle to efficiently inhibit AKT phosphorylation, so AKT activation. And as you can see from the Western blot on the right, we were able to demonstrate that both lipo and leucoponatinib were able to efficiently inhibit AKT phosphorylation and so AKT activation of 50% compared to friponatinib. So showing the ability of ponatinib nanoparticle to target, say, the same molecular targets of ponatinib, or at least share some of them. Of course, since I said that ponatinib is a multi-tyrosine kinase inhibitor, we will investigate other molecular targets involved in the different pathways. So, since I said that ponatinib has never been applied for the treatment of osteosarcoma, we were wondering which is the effect of ponatinib on a 3D model. So, on a 3D structure in order to better resemble the tumor structure and evaluate the effect of ponatinib on cancer stem cells that are the one that usually disseminate in the body and leads to metastasis formation. So first of all, we were able to efficiently grow spheroids, as you can see from the flow cytometry staining, in which we show an increase of cancer stem cell marker like CD44, CD133, and CD117, compared to the same cells cultured in adhesion. Then we evaluate the ability of ponatinib IC50 that we select from the 2D cell viability assay to efficiently inhibit spheroid formation, as you can see from the graph on the left. And then, as you can see from the panel, we were able to efficiently inhibit also spheroid growth over time in a dose-dependent manner, as well as decrease cell viability in a dose-dependent manner with friponatinib. Of course, all these experiments will be repeated also with ponatinib nanoparticle, but I can already anticipate that we are obtaining good results. Unfortunately, I couldn't show you yet, but in the meantime, I can show you that our nanoparticle were able to efficiently target the tumor sphere. I love this image. So I'm pretty happy from these results, and we were able to efficiently target the tumor spheroids, as you can see from the red dots that are the particle labeled. And I can show you that from the ZSTAC session that the particle were able not only to target the surface of the tumor spheroids, but they were also able to deeply penetrate inside the spheroid, reaching up to 80 micron in depth inside the spheroid. So we were able to efficiently target and also deeply penetrate inside the spheroids. So hoping that we can also efficiently release the drug and reaching the center of the tumor spheroids. Lastly, we evaluate the ability of ponatinib nanoparticle in efficiently target an in vivo model of osteosarcoma. So this is just a pilot experiment. We basically inject lipo-leucoponatinib, IV, and as you can see from the IVIS imaging, we were able to efficiently target the tumor lesion with both lipo and leucosome. Unfortunately, we didn't see a huge difference between the two formulations, as maybe we expected, but it's just a pilot experiment. And of course, we are looking forward to the therapeutic efficacy. So just to sum up, we were able for the first time to efficiently encapsulate ponatinib into biomimetic nanoparticle. We were able to demonstrate that this biomimetic nanoparticle has efficiently been uptaken by osteosarcoma cells both in 2D and in 3D. We showed a 30% improvement of drug cytotoxicity when it's encapsulated inside this nanoparticle. And for the first time, we were able to show the ability of ponatinib to inhibit sarcosphere formation and growth. And lastly, we also show an efficient targeting of our ponatinib nanoparticle in an in vivo model. So all this data, all these results, and this project paved the way for a translational application of this platform for the treatment of osteosarcoma. Thank you for your attention, and I'm happy to answer to all of your questions.